Asia is the largest of the seven continents, and in it, there are areas designating greater and lesser portions, such as the Southeast Asian region, which includes the Malay archipelago, where the state of Brunei Darussalam, meaning abode of peace, can be found on the northeast coast of the great island of Borneo, 443 kilometers north of the equator. One of the most ancient sovereign states in the region, Brunei Darussalam, a Malay Islamic monarchy with its unique water village or Kampung Ayer, can trace the pattern of its historical development back into the 6th century. This is Bandar Sri Begawan, the state capital and main center of population. Brunei Darussalam, with an area of 5,765 square kilometers and a population of almost a quarter of a million, is an oil and gas rich state. It has a per capita income of about $17,000 a year, giving its people one of the highest standards of living in Asia. The Omar Ali Saifuddin Mosque in the capital center is one of the nation's most beautiful buildings and a landmark that symbolizes Islam as the official religion, although the practice of other faiths is allowed. There has been a remarkable change in the skyline of Bandar Sri Begawan. High-rise office complexes and apartment buildings have become a feature of the developing capital. Jalan Sultan, once almost wholly a road of traditional two-story shop houses, has distinctive buildings which indicate the course of future style. The capital has developed along similar lines as that of the other three districts, but the distinction here is the new government projects, such as the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, just a few hundred meters away from the Ministry of Culture, Youth and Sports, the High Court adjoining the Ministry of Law building, the Ministry of Religious Affairs, and many more which have either been completed or are in development plans. In addition to the commercial and government buildings, another landmark is the superb Istana Nurul Iman, where His Majesty the Sultan and Yang di-Pertuan Negara Brunei Darussalam lives. The palace is open to members of the public during Hari Raya Aidilfitri for the subjects to greet His Majesty and the royal family. From the 16th century, Brunei Darussalam has been the center of a mighty empire which stretched from most of northern Borneo to far north in the Philippines. But at the end of the 19th century, it had reached its nadir, much of its territory and almost all of its power having been lost in the colonial expansion in Southeast Asia. Brunei Darussalam became a British protectorate in 1906. The finding of oil in the 1920s brought in a new economic era and set Brunei Darussalam on the path to great wealth. Self-government was introduced in 1959, and in 1967, Sultan Haji Omar Ali Saifuddin Sa'adul Khairi Waddin who had reigned for 17 years, voluntarily abdicated in favor of his son, Sultan Hassan al-Bolkiah Muizzeddin wad-Dawla, who became the 29th in a line of rulers going back to the 15th century. Sultan Haji Omar Ali Saifuddin Sa'adul Khairi Waddin, who died in September 1986, was the architect of modern Brunei. In 1979, a treaty signed between Brunei Darussalam and the United Kingdom provided for full independence by midnight on 31st December 1984, and Brunei Darussalam became the world's 159th sovereign state. There followed membership of the Commonwealth, the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, ASEAN, the United Nations, and the Organization of Islamic Conference.
We wish to assure this assembly that we accept fully the obligations enshrined in the United Nations Charter. Together with other member states, we will always strive to realize these aims and objectives. We genuinely believe in the preservation of world peace through collective security. We endorse the promotion of economic development through mutual help. We will uphold the principles that each country has the inalienable right to establish its own form of government without any form of outside interference and always having regard to the prevailing circumstances in each country and aspirations of its own people for a better standard of livelihood and well-being.
Waving proudly in the wind, the flag of Brunei Darussalam took its place among the 158 other national flags that stand at the center of what has been called the diplomatic crossroads of the world.
Economically, Brunei Darussalam is excessively dependent on the production of crude oil and natural gas. Annual oil production in 1985 was estimated at 61.3 million barrels, or 168,000 barrels a day, down from a peak of 261,000 barrels a day in 1979, under the depletion policy, which seeks to ensure a set recovery rate suited to economic needs. Brunei Darussalam is the world's fourth largest producer of liquefied natural gas. A plant set up in 1973 exports 5 million tons annually to Japan under a 20-year contract ending in 1993. Brunei Darussalam is planning to reduce its dependence on food imports, now about 90%. The aim is to produce 30% of its rice needs as soon as possible. Feasibility studies are being made where mechanized rice production may be possible. Other agricultural fields include vegetables, poultry, tropical fruits and livestock to ensure sufficient consumption needs. The country has other natural resources, most of which are still untapped. Forests cover 4,352 square kilometers, or 75% of the total land area of Brunei Darussalam. Although a large part of the country is covered by timber, its contribution to the economy is minimal. Logging in Brunei Darussalam is confined to meeting the local demand for timber. Timber production averaged 65,000 tons annually. Major efforts are being made to expand and modernize Brunei Darussalam's fishing industry. Through the Fisheries Department, the government is presently putting emphasis, which includes the intensification of new fishing methods to help improve the fishermen's income and catch, and studying the possibility of extending fishing areas to more than 300 kilometers, and the development of aquaculture. Local production of fish averaged 2,000 tons, while imports totaled 2,500 tons annually. In 1985, it was estimated that about 86,000 people were working with the government and private sectors. 61.3% of them are local, and 38.7% are expatriates. Local participation in the government and private sectors has constantly increased. Under the 5-year National Development Plan, the government has taken measures to diversify the economy by encouraging development in other fields. In the latest development plan, 1986 to 1990, the government has allocated 3.7 billion Brunei dollars for the purpose. It includes social services, transport and communications, public utilities, industry and commerce, public buildings, security, and miscellaneous expenses, all of which need skilled manpower. With its continuous economic growth, Brunei Darussalam has developed an efficient transportation network and acquired one of the most modern telecommunication systems among developing countries. There is a modern international airport at Bandar Seri Begawan, fully equipped with sophisticated visual and electronic approach and landing aids in accordance with international standards. It has a nearly 4,000-meter runway that is capable of handling jumbo jets and Concords. The newly completed development scheme includes the expansion of the passenger and cargo facilities and also the extension of the hangar and taxiway to be able to meet present and anticipated increase in air traffic activities over the next decades. In 1985, the airport served 380,000 passengers and handled almost 9,000 tons of air freight. The government-owned Royal Brunei Airlines, formed in 1974, has a record which few small airlines can match. From its first flight, linking Bandar Seri Begawan with Singapore, it has grown steadily. And today, the airline flies from Hong Kong to Darwin and to ASEAN countries and has its sight on other destinations. It moved directly into jet aircraft using Boeing 737s and Boeing 757s. In the development plans, which take into account increased traffic movement, the building of roads and flyover projects are of prime importance. The Public Works Department is responsible for the maintenance of more than 1,000 kilometers of roads, ranging from highways to earth roads. In recent years, there has been considerable development with the construction of long coastal roads, as well as many flyovers, connecting a series of major roads in Bandar Seri Begawan. The main Muara port, about 28 kilometers from the capital, can accommodate ships over 196 meters LOA and has taken vessels in the region of 2,000 gross tons. Extensive improvements have been made to all its facilities. As an in and out gate, it also plays an important part in the state's economic development. More than 500 ships call at the port annually, with an average of 1,000 tons of cargo being unloaded daily. Brunei Darussalam has one of the best telecommunication systems in Southeast Asia. Telecommunication services have improved considerably over the years. Indeed, the Thalesi Earth Satellite Station has been rated by Intelsat as the best in the world for its operational reliability. To meet the ever-increasing demand, the telecommunications department has responded by introducing subscriber trunk dialing and providing an electronic telephone exchange with a total capacity of about 23,000 lines. This also provides direct international dialing facilities to more than 100 countries. When it came into full operation in 1975, Brunei's television service, which operates on the PAL system, was the first all-color service in the region. A wide range of programs produced locally and overseas is transmitted. The commissioning of satellite stations also led to better and quicker transmission of international news.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Berita-berita utama, Amerika Syarikat menentang ketetapan Majlis Keselamatan Bangsa Masa Bersatu yang menghendaki Israel menghormati hak awam.
Radio transmission in Brunei Darussalam goes back to 1957, when programs were transmitted only 2.25 hours each day. Its services have been extended steadily, and today there are over 30 hours of transmission daily on two radio networks, one broadcasting in Malay and the other in English, Chinese and Nepali. Development of medical and health services has made Brunei Darussalam a healthier place. Malaria has been eradicated, and the state is cholera and typhoid free, and the infant mortality rate has been reduced by half. Medical facilities are free to Brunei citizens and those in the government service. This is the Raja Isteri Pangeran Anak Saleha General Hospital of 530 beds. Equipped with sophisticated facilities, it's one of the most modern in the region. It is the center for medical treatment in the country, though there are smaller hospitals in the other three districts. The school health services, meanwhile, cover nearly 200 schools with a student population of over 53,000.
Kita pun menyamakan tentang mengajar sesuatu kemahiran.
Brunei Darussalam has a literate population, but plans to further increase educational standards and has allocated millions of dollars for this purpose. At present, there are nearly 200 government educational institutions throughout the country, from primary to secondary schools, vocational and technical colleges, nursing and teachers' colleges, an Institute of Technology, an Institute of Education, and a university. In addition, there are scores of further education centers for adults and non-government schools. There is free primary education for 6 years, followed by 3 years secondary education for those who show ability. Scholarship can lead to tertiary education overseas, either in the academic or vocational fields, although vocational training is given locally. The University of Brunei Darussalam seeks to enable the education system to become more comprehensive. At the moment, degree courses of 4 years include Islamic teachings, Malay language and literature, mathematics and physics. Currently, there are about 2,000 Bruneians training overseas, many on government scholarship.
Oleh itu timbullah usaha yang menggalakkan bagi mengadakan satu sistem
As educational development takes place, Brunei Darussalam is already capable of producing graduates locally, and these future potential leaders will join the ranks of the many scholars who have graduated overseas. The development of houses in the country has increased over the years. Under the National Development Plan, the government allocated a provision for housing development in accordance with the target to provide sufficient houses with public facilities. One of the long-term plans is to ensure that every citizen will have a house. In addition, there are houses built by the private sector to cater to needs presently in line with the state housing development program. Religious programs cover a wide range of activities in line with the government's aspiration to make Islam a way of life for the people. During the Maulud Nabi celebration, Prophet Muhammad's birthday every year, huge gatherings such as this show the strength of faith of Muslims united in upholding Islamic teachings. His Majesty the Sultan Haji Hassan al-Bolkiah Muizzaddin Wad Dawla and the royal family are among the crowd marching for the annual celebration. One area of great attention for His Majesty is to meet his subjects closely, at the same time giving them the opportunity to present any problems of common interest.
Menyusul semula dan melantik menteri kabinet baru bagi memastikan dan melicinkan lagi pentadbiran.
Di perhimpunan yang permai ini, beta ingin menegaskan kepada penghulu-penghulu Ketua-ketua kampung dan rakyat di mukim ini akan perlunya kita hidup bersatu padu dan bermuafakat di dalam kehidupan seharian untuk menjamin keharmonian dan kesejahteraan kita semua. Keharmonian ini akan dapat dicapai dengan mengamalkan dan menghidupkan semula amalan hidup yang telah diamalkan oleh orang-orang tua kita dahulu kala. Yang sentiasa mengadakan permuzakarahan dan kata sepakat sesama anak-anak buah kampung dan memucang-mucang di dalam membuat sebarang pekerjaan yang berkebajikan. Di dalam kehidupan mereka, mereka juga saling hormat menghormati di antara satu dengan lain dengan mengamalkan hidup bersopan santun dan beradat istiadat. Adalah juga menjadi tanggungjawab penghulu-penghulu dan ketua-ketua kampung supaya sentiasa memberikan perhatian mereka mengenai dengan suasana dan keadaan kampung kerana setiap perkara sumbang yang berlaku di kalangan penduduk mukim atau kampung ianya akan menjadi punca keaipan dan mencemarkan nama baik mukim di kampung. Hendaknyalah nilai-nilai dan ciri-ciri hidup yang mana juga menjadi sumber ketahanan bangsa orang-orang Brunei yang beta nyatakan tadi akan dikekalkan dan diamalkan dan tidak ditukar ganti dengan nilai-nilai asing.
Berapa umur sudah?
Ada lah. Satu lah.
Buatlah kan. Dalam 100 juga. Dalam 100 juga.
Okay.
A grand welcome for Malaysia's paramount ruler and his wife, and a great honor for Brunei Darussalam when two kings meet to bind a close relationship sealed between their countries and their peoples. Since independence, great numbers of foreign leaders and delegates have visited Brunei Darussalam, and one of the most frequent has been Mr. Lee Kuan Yew, the Singapore Prime Minister. Dato' Mahathir Mohamad represented another close friend and neighbor, Malaysia. Ceremonial occasions such as credential presentations and audiences symbolize the friendly links His Majesty has established far, such as Oman, and near, as in the case of the Philippines. Brunei Darussalam has widened its relationship internationally and is a member of several international organizations. To further strengthen friendship and mutual understanding, diplomatic activities take into account visits to friendly countries. In the Pacific region, His Majesty, accompanied by Her Majesty Raja Istri Pangeran Anak Saleha, royal family and state dignitaries, visited South Korea and Japan. His Majesty and Her Majesty made a courtesy call on His Majesty Hirohito. Within the ASEAN region, His Majesty, again accompanied by Her Majesty Raja Istri Pangeran Anak Saleha, visited the Republic of Indonesia and was welcomed by President Suharto, his wife, and other Indonesian high officials. In Manila, capital of the Republic of the Philippines, His Majesty, accompanied by his brother Prince Haji Mohamed Bolkiah, the foreign minister, and high government officials, attended the 20th ASEAN summit meeting. This is one of many high-level conferences attended by His Majesty since independence.
The Sultan of Brunei Darussalam to deliver his closing statement.
We are very happy with the various agreements reached at this historic meeting, in particular in relation to functional cooperation. Brunei will be pleased to play an active part in the launching of a program on the exchange of youth within ASEAN. The agreements on intra-ASEAN economic cooperation are a step in the desired direction. Our goals are clear. Our strategy is mapped out, and we have now to let the ministers, officials, and the private sector implement our decision. When we meet again in the future, no doubt we will wish to review progress.
Back home, His Majesty Sultan Haji Hasan al-Bolkiah Muizzuddin Wadaulah, as Prime Minister and the Minister of Defense, spares much time visiting the Royal Brunei Armed Forces. This is one of an extensive operational exercises which involve every element of the forces, that exercises that test the capabilities for any eventuality. while Brunei Armed Forces is entrusted with the responsibility of defending the country's sovereignty, peace, security and harmony.